Hello again, everyone, and welcome to this ECHO face-to-face meeting. So once again, due to the pandemic, we have this face-to-face meeting as a remote meeting. Hopefully, it's the last meeting we have this way, and we are really looking forward to being able to see you in person for this meeting. So welcome to all ECHO members, and also welcome to all external participants. So this face-to-face is mainly dedicated to presenting ECHO results, and we have opened this face-to-face to a wide community. So thank you for joining and for enjoying this nice presentation. So I will do a very short introduction to the meeting, especially maybe for people who are not in the project. And then we have, I would say, a very full schedule with many interesting presentations. So let me start quickly by presenting ECHO. So ECHO is a H2020 Center of Excellence dedicated to using HPC to promote and help the energy transition. So ECHO is at the crossroad of two revolutions, the numerical and the energy revolution. So as you know, HPC is undergoing a major change as the next generation of exascale system is being deployed. You need to have really a huge energy reduction for this system to be tractable. You need really to change the way you design your application by being able to use really 10 of millions of computing elements, by being able to master heterogeneous computing. And so this transition will really require a radical innovation in computing technology, both hardware and software. And ECHO is really tackling the software side, trying to develop new applications for energy application. In this graph on the left side, you have this circle represent the surface of the circle are proportional to the amount of available energy. The little brown circle to the left is what we need every year worldwide. And then you have all these circles which represent various energy sources. And you can see that if we do well, renewable energy are really enough to power the world. And so ECHO is really trying to use the new potential offered by the exascale infrastructure to accelerate the transition towards the use of these energies. So ECHO is a wide consortium. We have 7 countries, 18 partners, and you can see on the map there. And among these 18 partners, we have a research institute, university, and one SME. It's a 3-year project that will likely be extended a bit. And I would say it's the second phase of ECHO because we have been building this ECHO 2 project and the experience that we have gained during ECHO 1. So the project is structured as follows. So we wanted in ECHO 2 to be really focused toward exascale bottleneck. So the project is really focused around 4 technical work packages: scalable solver, programming model, IO and data flow, and ensemble run. And these technical challenges are there to power and help our scientific challenges, which are wind for energy, meteo, material, water, and fusion, and all of that for, with an energy perspective. So I will detail a bit all these technical and scientific challenge, starting with the scientific challenge. So the scientific challenge are wind for energy, so meteo, material, water, and energy. So for each of these, you have a clear scientific objective and a strong impact. And we are really each time working on a production application and not mini app. So really trying to develop the code and enhance the code used by these scientific communities. So I will go through the scientific challenge one by one. So wind for energy. So we have two tasks there. One is the development and verification and validation on to model flow over a complex terrain. So often when you place a windmill on complex terrain, the wind flow is perturbed, and it's very important to be able to master this effect. And it's also very computationally demanding. And we have another task at much smaller sets, which is to develop a full rotor simulation and the coupling of the rotor and on the wing flow, modeling the moving rotor. So for that, the main flagship code is ALIA, and we have other satellite code. And we have really been trying to extend ALIA and to optimize it for this this kind of windmill modelization problems. The other scientific challenge, next one, is meteorology for energy. So there, the idea is to do short-term meteorological prediction, mainly to be able to couple renewable energy sources to the grid. To be able to predict the production of windmill or on a solar farm. So we do a continuous probabilistic short-term prediction of optical thickness and wind. So this is optical thickness, of course, is for a solar farm, and wind is for windmill production. Wind and solar power calculation for meteorological ensemble, and we try to calibrate ensemble prediction also both for wind and optical thickness. So it's very important if you want to be able to use efficiently and in a secure way renewable energy sources to be able to predict rare event to avoid many failure of the electricity network. So that's why this challenge is tackling. Then we have another challenge, is material for energy. There, the idea is really to work on a new material and try to design new material and assess property of a new material, mainly for photovoltaic cells, battery, and supercapacitor. So it's really dedicated to a small scale atomistic simulation of this device. And we're working on a hetero interface in silicon sonar cells, on trying to get electricity from salinity or temperature gradient, and also of a new kind of solar cells based on perovskite. So it's really tackling a storage and production of electricity. The one before last scientific challenge is water for energy. So then we are in this challenge, we are dealing with two aspects. One is in really to try to assess the capacity and production capability of hydropower, if possible, taking into account climate change. And the other wise is to assess and to modelize the potential of a geothermal reservoir and trying to see how best to use this geothermal reservoir. So there we have two flagship codes, the PARFLOW and the schemat suite. And we are trying to port this code to GPU and really to make the best usage of them to assess the capacity of these two energy sources. And finally, the last scientific challenge is on fusion for energy. So it's a longer term perspective. So this is in the framework of the ITER project. And there, we are really trying to develop codes to model plasma inside tokamak. And we are mainly focusing on the GZLA code, which is very computationally demanding because it's a 5D gyrokinetic code. So you have a very large phase space since it's five-dimensional. So it's a huge challenge, both in terms of computation and also to extract data and treat the data that comes out of this code. So now the idea of ECHO is really to help this code by tackling a specific exascale bottleneck. So the first work package dedicated to this is work package 2, which is dedicated to new programming model. So for each of these scientific challenges, you have here the name, the flagship code, and what has been done. So you can see that within this work package, we have really been trying to optimize, to refactor, and to really modernize all the code by implementing, for example, new AMR feature in Parflow, by implementing a new I/O pattern, or by porting the code to GPU, or by optimizing pure monocore performance of the code, or by testing a COCOS or new programming paradigm. So this work package is really dedicated to this. For Mathieu, so we are using press resources. I will not go into the detail into this introduction, but we really need to test the code, and we need press resources for that. And so if you have issue with this, Mathieu Lobé is the person to contact. The next technical work package is about linear algebra. So the goal of this work package is really to design and implement exascale-enabled linear algebra solvers that are used in many applications. So for wind, for water, or for fusion, you often end up with a linear system to solve. And in this work package, we have really a large amount of team expert in linear algebra. So we really have a constellation of various solvers. You have all them here that are used in ECHO. And so for all these solvers, we are really the people developing the solver, and so the best expert worldwide, for this solver. And we are working together, so the scientific expert and the linear algebra expert, to find the best solver for a given problem, and to try to have a solver efficient and that is able to scale well enough to bring the code to exascale system. So the type of activity is can be interfacing available solver to flagship code, so just code coupling, or this solver can be extended to improve robustness or scalability for a given specific problem. And we can also design and develop a specific application solver, so driven by the use of application and by end users, which is more work. But since we have the expert, we are able to do that. And so there will be a three talk. I will not detail them here, presenting a result of this work in linear algebra. The one before last work package is I/O and data flow. So there, the idea is really to be able to treat the flow of data going through large-scale simulation in the best possible way. So for that, we are developing a PDI, parallel data interface, which can really be a middle layer between application and I/O library, to ease the use of I/O and also to be able to do in situ data analytics when needed. And we have also been working, especially with DDN, to do a lot of I/O refactoring and optimization, especially using the IME interface developed by DDN and CopyXine to various I/O library. And so all these tools that we developed have been implemented in our flagship code, so Zigella, Parflow, Schemat, ESIAS, and so they are really being employed to make our flagship code more efficient. So you will have a first simulation of that this afternoon by Konstantinos Chasipis from DDN. And then we are also working on fault tolerance and in situ and in transit data manipulation, which is a key aspect for some of the simulation we do when it's not possible to store all the data. So Kai Keller from BSC will present that, the coupling of MELISA and FTI really to help make the code more resilient and fault tolerance proof. So that will be tomorrow. And tomorrow you will have also in situ data analytics and visualization using PDI. We also have a last work package. I don't have any slide, but I will present it. So work package 5, which is more dedicated to ensemble run and workflow. The main tool of this work package is MELISA, and it's really very important to be able to tackle a complex workflow and to couple code. So we are really working a lot on this in ECO, and you will have also a lot of examples of what we can do with MELISA in presentation that will come. So I will stop here. It was meant to be a short introduction. So this whole afternoon and tomorrow morning, we have a scientific talk, so presenting all various aspects. So we have mixed talk presenting scientific results from our scientific challenge from the application side, another talk presenting a scientific result from our what we call a technical challenge. And the idea is to really to illustrate how the technical work done by a computer scientist can really be integrated into real life application and really help to promote and enhance the usage of HPC. So again, thank you very much for joining this face-to-face. We hope you will enjoy the presentation. They will all be recorded, so they will be available online if you want to go back to them, so both the presentation and the slide. So thank you again, and as I said, we hope to see you in person maybe this fall for our next face-to-face meeting. And now I will leave the floor to Kyle Rees from CEA, who is working with Mathieu Salan.